This is Greg Hutcheon from SAP S4HANA Cloud ERP Product Success, where we're kicking off the new year with some awesome new innovations as part of the 2502 release. In this video, we'll dive into some new features in solution order management and how they will help drive your solution-based business model to new heights in 2025. Let's take a look. The first innovation I want to share builds on the advanced solution bundling functionality, which we introduced last year. To recap, solution bundles are pre-configured products consisting of several items packaged together and sold as part of a solution order, designed to make selling complex and customizable solutions even more efficient. With the 2502 release, we deliver more flexible solution bundle selling by supporting more options for bundles pricing. Firstly, discounts can now be applied at the header level of a bundle, with the discounted price then being propagated to all follow-up documents automatically. What's more, specific pricing for sub-item components assigned to a bundle has also been introduced. To support bundle-specific pricing, we've introduced three new price condition types for solution orders, which can be maintained and adapted in the Manage Prices app. Condition type PSBP for bundled items which are charged as a one-off. Condition type PSMB, which is used for bundle sub-items charged on a recurring basis, such as service contract items. And a further price condition type, PSSK, has been introduced to cover items sold as part of a sales bill of material. The system automatically determines the item price when it is added to the solution order as part of a bundle or sales kit, and the price condition type is reflected under the Price Details tab on the item view. Upon releasing the solution order, the pricing details are reflected in all follow-up transactions for a seamless process, reducing manual effort and potential for input error when selling complex solution bundles with varied pricing parameters. This provides you with greater flexibility when defining pricing strategy for solution selling and can help improve business margins with a larger and more differentiated solution order offering. Moving on, let's take a look at the integration between solution order management and SAP subscription billing, where we've also made some updates with 2502. With this release, we've introduced further fields to solution order management, which make creating, modifying, and managing subscription products more efficient. When opening the detailed view of a subscription billing item in a solution order, you will now notice a new checkbox to create subscriptions as pending, which gives the solution order specialist control over when the subscription is activated. This field overwrites the original setting created in subscription billing, which will be taken over if the box remains unchecked. You will also notice a new header for subscription terms. Here you can adapt and override the default terms from SAP subscription billing and govern the lifecycle of a follow-up subscription directly in solution order management. Under the billing section, new fields for billing cycle and billing cycle reference date have been added, which can be used to determine when and how the system schedules billing. And new fields let you define whether recurring charges are billed together or waived, supporting more flexible subscription sales. To round off, you'll notice a new column in the price calculation view table for recurrence, which indicates the frequency recurring charges are billed. Of course, this is just a teaser, and you'll find more details and further new features from 2502 listed in my blog post, which is linked below. Make sure to check that out and keep up to date with the latest updates via the SAP S4HANA Cloud Public Edition community. Thank you for watching.